Hello everybody. So just decided to make a video because I keep getting these questions on my comment section about like COVID vaccine. So the question is, what's gonna be the story if you're not having your COVID vaccine, if you're not vaccinated? So it's way different from my experience, and like I am not really like knowledgeable about it because, as I said, it's not I am vaccinated and it's not like I was not experiencing of it. But for me, if you cannot contact, the best one is contact the SLEC. You go to the website and for sure they have their email there. Go to the internet and type SLEC or St. Luke Medical Center, and maybe they have their, I haven't checked, but for sure they have their email there. If it's not, like if they don't have like contact there, just do this. This is from my own perception, okay? If I am in that case, then I cannot contact the SLEC like directly because of some reasons. Like for example, they don't provide their email there in the website or whatever. Like there's no way to contact them, especially if you are from the islands in the Philippines, like Mindanao, Visayas, malayo ka sa Manila, so you cannot go there. You don't want to rest flying there. Na hindi ka sure kung ano mangyayari, if they're going to allow you or not. So if you cannot get the COVID vaccine for some reasons, like you have personal reason, like you have health concern, you don't really wanted to get that vaccine, punta ka sa RHU nyo, sa health center nyo, or di kaya sa yung local doctor nyo, yung community doctor nyo, punta ka doon, hingi ka ng certification about it with the reason why you don't want to get that vaccine. Okay? Then, yun yung ipakita mo dun sa SLEC. Mag-secure ka ng appointment mo, punta ka dun sa SLEC, dalhin mo lahat ng mga requirements nila, lahat ng mga papers na hinihingi nila except your COVID vaccine certificate because you don't have it. So, like yung mga 2x2 mo, ganun, dalhin mo yun lahat. Then, yung screenshot ng status mo na ready na para pwede ka nang mag-proceed para sa medical examination, dalhin mo yun. Tapos explain mo dun sa kanila. Kasi ang alam ko, hindi na talaga sapilitan na mag-vaccine ka. And also, US doesn't really require na vaccinated ka para makapag-entry ka sa country. So, I don't think SLEC will be super duper like strict when it comes to that. As long as you have valid reason, and yeah, as long as you have valid reason, then you're ready to go. And if you don't have the vaccine, they will for sure do something for it. Like they will maybe like do something like on your case. So like maybe they will give you a shot instead of COVID or something like that. So just do it. Like just go there. If you cannot contact them, just provide a certification from your rural health unit, na yung sa head nurse nyo or yung kaya sa doctor nyo na bakit kailangan hindi ka makakuha niyan. Then they will for sure like respect your reason. If you have health concern, then at least you have proof na hindi ka talaga pwedeng magkaroon ng ayun yan, ganyan. So reason lang. Kasi hindi naman talaga ganun ka-strict ang USA. So but better, kontakin mo muna sila. Right? Find ways na makontakt mo sila kung taga-island ka ng Pilipinas, island ka ng sa probinsya ka, malayo ka. So ganyan. Kasi there are lots of cases na mga ganun na walang vaccine. Kasi sa anak ko, hindi siya vaccinated. And I am vaccinated. And when we got there, because we both have different like schedule for our medical examination, then they asked me if vaccinated ba siya or hindi. Sabi ko lang wala. Then yun, undergo naman siya ng medical examination. So maybe, as far as I know, like parang may ano lang naman doon na i-check nila kung vaccinated ka. If not, then it's fine. So parang ganun lang. So try nyo na lang. Mag-research na lang kayo. Basta sa case ng anak ko, ano na siya, 13 years old. So parang young adult na siya. So medyo malapit na doon sa adult. So hindi naman nila na-required. Excuse me. So yun. Yun lang naman yung masasabi ko. Kasi napapagod na akong mag-type sa sumagot sa comment section tapos paulit-ulit. So, just decided to make a video of it. So, it's just a short video. So, thank you for watching and good luck. Have a good day. Bye-bye.